What's up, YouTube? What's up, Patreon friends? How are we all doing today? Man, I'm excited. It's like some of you can read my mind. I've been thinking about doing a Silk Sonic covers kind of like introduction. Not introduction, but like on our channel, you know what I mean? We can watch like some covers, some like tributes, like all this stuff, right? Because like we've watched all the Silk Sonic stuff together. And I mean, like a whole bunch of us have gone to Silk Sonic now. And it's just like, I think it would be a blast. And I think this would be a great way to get into it too, a salsa cover. So let's see if I can butcher these names real good. This is Gene Rodriguez, Noel Charis, Kenyi, and Tony Sukar. Some variation of those, of all those letters. Oh, that's not good. So I'm looking forward to this. I think a salsa cover of this. I can't even imagine how. Like, I'm trying to think about how it's going to sound in my head, and I have no clue. So I'm just going to jump into it and get into this. So I'm excited. I appreciate the request. My friend Tomas on Patreon. Y'all can check me out on Patreon as well if you want. The link's in the description box. Let me know if there's some more of these covers I got to check out, because I kind of want to make a thing out of this. YouTube, I appreciate y'all. Love y'all. So good to see everyone showing up in the comments and everything, seeing all the familiar names. I dig it, man. Let's do this. Look at this. Snake skin shirt. I dig it. All right, let's do this. Ooh, okay. What you doing? Where you at? Oh, you got plans? Don't say that. Sipping wine in a row. I look too good to be alone. My house clean, but no more. Just change. Little flair they're adding into a lot of this, man. It sounds like it's like a lot of like Bruno inspired flair. I dig it. It feels like it's like a Bruno track to me. I think it's really neat. They're doing a good job of this too, and these microphones are probably mostly for show, maybe a little bit of for like the tonal quality. They just look vintage, right? Like that's the kind of the shtick here, right? Real clean falsetto like that too. I dig that there's not like a drum kit when it comes to percussion. Like it's just percussion. You know, there's congos, bongos, there's all kind of, there's like the tamales, I think they're called. Or timbales. Timbales? Tamales is food, timbales. I can't remember. But like it's neat. It's a different vibe. It's a different approach, right? It gives it a real salsa vibe, like very like flowy and dancey. Like I don't know, man. I dig this. Great cover. That was a great run. I'm distracted. I wasn't talking about it. It was a great run. Great outro into the second verse here. Tell me that you're coming through. Oh, so sweet, so tight. I won't bite unless you like. And if you smoke, I got the haze. And if you're hungry, girl, I got fillets. Oh, baby. See a little grit in his voice on the fillets there. I dig that. Fantastic. That whole section right there was magical. Just magic. Rose petals in the bathtub, girl, let's jump in, it's bubbling. I ain't playing no games, every word that I say is coming straight from the heart. So if you're trying to play this song, I'ma leave the door open.
Both
these singers are like, they keep surprising me. Like, I think they're at the top and then they're not. Cause like that was a really great, like a very loud, almost like chest, like mix. I'm assuming it was like in their mix position. But like, wow, man, like there's some singers in this group. Bass boom, boom. It's so groovy. Whatever the pitches were, whatever, it doesn't matter. But it's so groovy. Snapping now, man. He's letting go. Like, he's letting it all out now. And like, it still sounds like there's like a lot of Bruno influence, man. I dig it. It's cool. Like, it sounds like he's covering a Bruno track and doing a good job of it. Like, and Bruno's all over this track, right? Like, it's cool. Right back to like this, the clean vocals, and then same thing, like we love that in Silk Sonic 2, right? Like I dig it, man. Man, is there subtitles or anything? This would be so cool if there is. I really hope that there is. Yeah, okay, let's see. They sound great together, man. Harmonizing back and forth like that. Their voices, like the backing vocalists, everyone's singing sounds fantastic, man. Like it sounds like they're very like tightly like developed group, right? This is cool. These captions, they're doing it for me. Nice, yeah, bring it back. I thought they would be utilizing this cymbal as a ride more, and this is the first time I'm noticing or catching it, but it sounds really nice, man. It adds to the mix. It adds like a really nice like brittle top end that none of the other percussion really has. Like there's no real like shakers or anything. The cowbell is gonna be like real throaty, like real kind of like mid heavy, right? So like it's neat that he's got the bell going right now. It just fills out like the rest of the mix really nice, right? Just sits in there nice. Yeah, bring it back down. See, like there's so much. I just think there's so much Bruno flair in there, man. And like if I could, I totally would too. If I could sound like Bruno, I would too. These singers are great, killing it, man. And like, even like I say, like their timbre. Like, however they're pronouncing, like, the leave part, it's just, like, they're doing it the exact same. And, like, we could say, like, leave or leave, like, whatever. But they have it, like, dialed in where it's, like, they've probably sat there and, like, made sure it's correct. And it shows, right? Like it's a recording they probably went through, made it perfect. That's all great. But it shows, like, little details like that. It's important because it sounds fantastic. Percussion player looked like he was having a blast. Percussion player was my favorite, the whole thing. I dug it, man. I dug it. Fantastic request. Fantastic start into this. And I'll watch them all, man. If it ends up being Leave the Door Open 10 times, that's fine. But I know there's some covers of Skate. I know there's some covers of some other ones. And I dig it. I dig it. I wish I knew what these microphones were. I might try to look into that. But the rest of it was really good. I think they had it set up mostly like it was a performance. So there wasn't a ton of like of the technical stuff of how they recorded it. Because like it would be cool to see how they did all like the acoustic drums and all the acoustic percussion parts, sorry, and everything, right? But I dug it, man. Great way. Great minds think alike. I hope that we can group ourselves in the category. See everybody again soon.